Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to discuss what alert or notification system you should use as a new streamer on Twitch. Then, at the end of the video, I'll walk you through how to set up some on-screen labels to display your latest stream supporters. Let's get right into it. If you're not familiar with an alert system or a notification system, they're applications that allow you to display on-screen events, which are generally when someone follows, subscribes, tips, or host your Twitch channel. So, in essence, they're a way to show an on-screen thank you to the people that are supporting you as a streamer. We're going to cover a quick list of different systems you can use and how they'd be beneficial to you, but before we do, I want to just say that on-screen alerts should probably be the last of your concerns. As a new streamer, there's a lot out there that you could do to improve your broadcast, such as finding ways to improve your audio and video quality, focusing on increasing viewer interaction, or most importantly, figuring out what makes streaming most fun for you. If you focus on having a good time and becoming a member of the Twitch community, you'll find that streaming has a lot more rewarding things to offer than just worrying about growing a huge audience. Anyways, alert systems can be used as a tool to assist with viewer interaction, so let's take a look at as many as we can. We'll start with Twitch Alerts. This application is probably the most popular out there, and for one big reason. It's easy to set up and understand. If I needed to set up a new stream, I could probably do it within 2 minutes while using Twitch Alerts. This application is mostly web-based, but like a couple of the other choices that we have, it has a downloadable program that we can run on our computer, and we can use that to monitor the alerts from our viewers. The program called Stream Labels will also update text files that we can bring into OBS. These text files can be used as a static on-screen label of who our recent follower was and a host of different options. Twitch Alerts also features an easy integration of on-screen Twitch chat as well as their event list, which could basically replace an overlay. While you can customize your alerts a bit, a downside of Twitch Alerts is that only their new features allow for direct CSS customization. In general, I found it to be a little bit difficult to make a lot of cool and custom ideas work inside of Twitch Alerts, and the system just feels a little bit dated. They're also the subject of a bit of controversy at the moment, but I don't know the full details on that. Anyways, let's move on to another alert system that is quite new, Muxi.io. This is my personal go-to alert system. I've been working with these applications for years now and was impressed when I first tried out Muxi. Like almost all of the systems we'll talk about, Muxi features a dashboard with analytics, an easy-to-set-up basic alert system, a downloadable program called the Ticker, and this will actually provide similar functions as Twitch Alerts. Muxi also makes it easy to set up alerts with Patreon, GameWisp, as well as integration with Discord. They even allow connections to Twitch Alerts, StreamTip, and Nightbot. If some of these names don't sound familiar, don't worry, we'll talk about them very soon. So why do I use Muxi? As a person with a background in graphic and web design, I can create completely customized alerts using HTML, CSS, and even JavaScript. My personal alerts are some fun animations that would be a major headache to set up in some of the other alert systems. Another thing about Muxi is that they seem to respond quickly to customer support requests. I sent them a request for an idea that I had, and after they replied, the new feature was up and running within a few days. Now, I'm sure that won't happen with every idea, but it was pretty cool to see. Unfortunately, the downside of Muxi has been their reliability. As a new system, alerts can sometimes take a while to come through, and users have reported issues to where they're not shown at all. I hope these are just growing pains, and I would really love to see Muxi become very popular. Another popular option is StreamPro.io. I actually made a full video about StreamPro, so if you're interested, check that out in the description below to watch that video. One thing that has changed since the video, though, is that StreamPro is now under the same company as Twitch Alerts. This makes a lot of sense to me, as I feel that StreamPro brings a lot to the table and is a bit more current than Twitch Alerts. This app is actually a lot more than just a notification system. It features an easy-to-use overlay system to where you can add in different widgets and customize them to your liking. Once you're done, you can bring in your design to OBS or any streaming software, via the browser source. So in essence, your overlay and alert system is saved in the cloud. You can also work from pre-built templates, which allow you to get graphics added into your stream within minutes. Notable widgets are their Twitter feed, straw poll, and simple to add Twitch chat. StreamPro's communication and updates have seemed to fall off a bit, but I'm assuming that has to do with their new partnership with Twitch Alerts. I'm interested in seeing new things that they'll bring to the table. Again, if you'd like a full overview of the system, check out the link to the video in the description below. Another new system that I just haven't had the time to fully experience and review is Gaming for Good. This platform originally began as a way for streamers to raise funds for charities, but has evolved into so much more. From what I've seen so far, it's very quick and responsive and easy to set up. A really cool part is that you can set specific percentages of your tips that you earn to go to integrated charities such as Save the Children, or you can set the full amount to go to yourself. It also has a cool YouTube Jukebox that allows viewers to pay for songs and be played on your stream. I wish I knew a little bit more about this system, but unfortunately I just haven't had enough time to fully evaluate it. So as you can see, there's a lot of systems out there and they work in similar ways. They're fairly simple to set up and accomplish most of the same tasks. I quickly want to mention StreamTip before we walk through setting up our on-screen labels and Twitch chat. StreamTip is a simple to use tip platform. It's very basic and perfect for someone that just wants the basic on-screen labels of recent supporters. It's created by NightDev, which is a company that makes a lot of great applications such as Nightbot and Better Twitch TV. They offer a couple of alert systems, but none of them are on the level of what we've discussed so far, other than StreamTip. Alright, so since Twitch Alerts is the most popular system out there and shares a lot of the same features as everything else, let's set it up very quickly. Now, I do want to mention that most of the concepts behind what we're doing will actually apply to most of the other systems. Meaning, if you set up Twitch Alerts, you'd have no problem setting up anything else as well. Let's first log into Twitch Alerts and then go to the Donation Settings tab. Here, I can quickly link my PayPal account and begin accepting donations or tips for my stream. We can configure a couple of options here if needed, but the most notable part of this section is the donation page. This is the page that we'll want to direct our viewers to if they'd like to support our channel. More on that in our next video. Anyways, with that set up, let's download their Stream Label application so that we can put labels into OBS. Once the application is downloaded and installed, let's launch it. The first thing that we need to do is select an output directory. This is where all the text files will be stored. These files will contain the names of our latest followers, tippers, and much more. If we ever need to update this location, we can click Change Output Directory at the top. It's important to create a folder for these files to be stored in, since there will be a lot of them made. I'll select my Alerts folder on the desktop. Now, let's set up our labels inside of OBS. In my gaming scene, I'll add a text source and call it Latest Follower. Let's place it and size it before we link it to our new text file. I'll just put in a name in the text box to simulate a new follower. I'll select a font and set my size to 26. Now I'll just click and drag it into place and use the arrow keys for any fine adjustments as needed. Once it's placed where we'd like, we can then link the appropriate text file. Let's go back into the source property and checkmark the Read From File option. Let's hit Browse and then navigate to where our Alerts folder is. We'll see a ton of different text files that will allow us to add different labels into our stream. In this case, I want to add in the most recent follower.txt file. We should see a name appear if we have any recent followers. We can now do the same thing to the other parts of our overlay as well. But let's say I wanted to add a list of followers instead of just one person. One thing I can change in the text file is to point it to the sessions follower.txt. This will display multiple followers. I can go back into Stream Labels and then click File Settings. Next, I'll use the dropdown to find the settings for this file. We can see here that I can edit the template of how this file displays. This means I can choose what comes before the entire list of names, or even specify what text before each name. I can set a separator, which I'll just leave as a comma. And then I can specify the item limit. I'll leave this at the default and go back into OBS. We'll see that the list of name goes well into the next areas of my overlay and even off screen of my preview window. To fix this, I can simply apply a filter to the source. I'll set up a scroll filter, give it a horizontal speed of around 20, and then limit the width, which is sort of like cropping, to 380. We'll see that everything is looking a lot better now, and we can repeat this process and use our knowledge of filters and add text sources to make the rest of the overlay how we'd like it. In a future video, I'll cover adding in the on-screen alerts, and in other videos I've made, I covered how to add music tickers into OBS. So make sure to subscribe or watch the videos in the description below. Let's add in the last items we need to complete our overlay. I want to put Twitch chat into our in-between scene. To do this, we can use Twitch Alerts chat box. Simply grab the URL listed towards the top and then tweak any settings how you'd like them. I prefer to use the box version. And then after I hit save settings, let's go back into OBS and add in a browser source and name it Twitch chat. In the URL, I'll paste the URL that I just copied from Twitch Alerts. I'll set the width and height to an appropriate value. In this case, I have a lot of vertical space to work with, so I'll set it to 484 by 878 pixels, and then I'll hit OK. I won't see anything yet since no one is talking in my chat. However, I can position the box where I'd like to in my scene, and then I'll go ahead and start spamming my chat to see if it's working. Okay, with that, you should now have the ability to create your own scenes and add in everything that you'd need. I want to mention two quick things. First, if you want to reuse the text sources across different scenes, don't forget that the filters and properties of each source will actually carry over into different scenes. So it may be easier to add in separate sources depending on your situation. Last, adding in the on-screen pop-up notifications work the same way as adding in Twitch chat. You basically grab a URL, add it into OBS Studio, give it a width and a height, and position it where you like. They even have buttons to hit to test to see if things are working. I hope you find this video very helpful in selecting the notification system that works for your stream, and there are a lot of them out there, even more than I covered today. I'd really like to hear in the comments below what notification system you're using or your thoughts on the ones we talked about in this video. If you like this video, please give it a like. And if you really like the video, make sure to subscribe for more great streaming and video game related content from Nerd or Die. Thanks for watching.